Hi, and welcome to day three, and I hope you got over all the excitement of the Grand National yesterday and the other races at Aintree. But we've got nine races for you today to finish up week 11. We're coming from Haydock and Hereford, and the first race of the day is going to be the Betfair Handicap Chase Final over at Haydock over 2 miles, 6 furlongs. Top weight there is going to be San Yokin for Darren Thompson, rated 128. You've got Starfen in there for Kevin Meenahan off of 120. There's a few more. It's a nice big field. I think anybody probably could win that. Now we'll move us on to the Betfair Handicap Hurdle Final, which is over 2 mile, 4 furlongs, also at Haydock, and a very small field there of 8 going to post, and it's one where even one trainer's got 2 in there, so there's only 7 trainers represented. Top of the weights on the handicap on the hurdle is going to be Scooby Snacks, followed by If You Want Blood from Martin Leader. And then I think Musty Mutt of Stu Gray, after such a disappointing Cheltenham, is looking to sneak this one off a rating of just 101. So good luck to him. So race 27 is the Tim Maloney Handicap Chase, still at Haydock. It's over 3 mile, 4 furlongs. Again, a nice big field there. Plenty of trainers representative. If I was to stick my nose out, I think Coupe de Ville for Doug Warren is well rated off 106. Came second last time out, looking to go one step better. And if we look further down the field, the only other one that's got really any form is Streets of War of late, who came third last week for Darren Howes. Again, probably one for anybody. Then we move on to race 28, which is the Daffodil Vase Handicap Chase, where top-rated Kingdom of Our Lord for Joshua Southern were looking to get a little bit better than his third place at Cheltenham last week. Well, it's Surfer Molto Stupido, winner of last week's Cheltenham race, so he'll be looking to follow up, but going off a now rated 151. Further down the card, Hollywood Broke the Gate, also a winner last week, running off of 121. And then right down the bottom, not a lot of form, but Stony Bridge for Kevin Meenahan came second last time out and is only rated 108 for this one. That moves on to race 29, and we move over to Hereford for the final 5, and we've got the Hereford Club Handicap Hurdle to start us off over 3 miles. Again, a reasonably good field there. If I had to pick out anybody, it would be Quack for Kevin Meenahan, Radio Missile for Alex Cherry, Sea Devil for Graham Plutterbuck. All in the money and some good form, but Montoya's right down the bottom for James Follis, that won last week over the Fakenham Tight Bends. Whether he can follow up here at Hereford, who knows. Then we move on to race 30, which is Moore's Millions, leg 13 over 3 mile, 3 furlongs. Again, plenty in there to looking to qualify. Form's a bit sketchy all round. Phantasmagoria for Sirius Chul, winner last week, looking to follow up, rated 116. He'll be running approximately about 9-10 pounder below the top weight, which is Break Free of Molly at Surfer. So I think that one's got a really good chance. Then race 31, it's the leg 14 of the Moore's Million Stairs. This one's over a slightly extended version. It's a 3 mile, 7 furlong. Again, some not with a lot of form. You've got probably Pula, that came second last time out. Emperor Fountain for Kevin Meenahan was third. And right down the bottom, Comanche, who came fourth last week at Cheltenham, as I know the trainer. I think it's a little bit short for him. Then we move on to the Starters Orders qualifiers. The hurdle's up first, which will be leg 9. It'll be race 32 on your card over 2 miles, 2.5 furlongs. Probably best horse in there is Frantic Eskimo, David Robertson. It's won 2 of its last 4 starts. It won last time out. It'll be going off a rating of 126, although not top weight. And its top weight is going to be Black Widow for Molly at Surfer. And then the last race of the day to finish off week 11 is the Chase version of the qualifiers. It's leg 9. It's over 2 miles, 2.5 furlong. Again, a really good field in there. Top weight's going to be Call the Nurse of David Robertson. Eagle has landed for Joshua Sutton. It's just a pound lower. And then you've got Witch's Sticks, was a winner last time out for Leon Van Rensburg, going off of 124. Says it needs a little bit further. Made in Archer, a great winner last week at Cheltenham, coming in here off of 122. But I think he won over a hurdle last week. And then towards the bottom, probably Run for Your Lives, a Serious Chul have a chance, as well as Pipe and Lied for James Follis. Well, that's it for the week. I hope everybody had a good week, and we'll see you for week 12, the penultimate week. Goodbye.